around here.
Watch out!
Let's skedaddle. Hi.
This way.
I'm looking for a stop.
Now before more arrive. This way.
Oh.
Enough!
Okay.
No.
Oh. Oh, yay. Hold on, I want to see all the stuff I got first. Never mind, that's it.
It is over.
It is far from over.
It's gonna be okay, Tyr.
You've seen what is to come. I told you I would not follow you to war, and yet here I am, dragging an innocent elf and marching towards the destruction of Asgard.
What choice do we have?
There is always a choice. I will not lead you to war. I won't. I'm not that god anymore. I don't want to fight. But with you three, there is no avoiding it. Your path leads to countless deaths, unimaginable pain and suffering.
Oh no!
Oh. No!
Atreus!
Bollocks!
Hold on!
Over here! Your chains!
Sir. Hey, Tyr. Thanks. And
I'm sorry about before.
No. I am sorry. I should never have come. We shouldn't linger.
Look, I just want to do the right thing. And according to prophecy...
Speak no more of prophecy.
War will not give you the purpose you seek, Atreus. Only slaughter.
So what are we supposed to do? Roll over? Do nothing?
Enough! We will discuss our next move when you are out of danger.
Dark Elf Assault. How fortuitous.
I'm so sick of fighting elves. Can't they just leave us alone?
Oh, I don't have to fly.
Father, this way!
here. Let's keep moving.
Oh, hello. The Alpha.
Can we leave now, please?
Almost there. This way.
Oh, Lord.
Tyr, we...
Open the gateway, please.
Yourself the legacy this one has left for the Barons. I've had far more than I can stomach.
We do not need to rush. We should see this desert for ourselves.
I know we can't trust prophecy, but I'm not sure we should just ignore what we saw either.
We are not ignoring it. We...
Hold on. Oh, I know what that is.
We'll discuss it back home. For now, I wish to search for the wounded animal you heard earlier.
You? Really?
Yes.
Well, okay then. Good. Yeah, lead the way.
We should be able to reach the Barons up top. Once we find a way past this hive matter.
I remember this thing. Definitely Dark Elf territory.
Oh, how about that? Circle back around.
Hey, Mimir. Between me and Tyr, who'd ever guess I was the giant, huh?
Indeed, lad.
Okie dokie.
Hail, fellow travelers!
Atreus heard a creature in pain in the desert.
Over a storm like this? Most impressive.
You know Alfheim pretty well, right? Do you have any idea what's out there?
No, sorry. The elves and I... Long story, but it's best when we keep out of each other's way. Hive matter is... stickier than I care for. Good luck on your search, though.
Well, thank you.
Stuff some cloth in your ears to keep the sand out. Don't knock it till you've tried it.
Surprised to see you out here, Sindri. You must hate the sand.
Oh, it is the worst. But with Brock banned from Alfheim, it's up to me to keep you ship-shape and sharp.
So why is Brock banned from Alfheim?
Oh, that's, I don't know if... Well... Do you know what a juicy gnocchi is?
No.
Well, thanks to Brock, the elves sure do.
What is a juicy...
No.
Brock? Why?
This axe just keeps getting stronger.
Indeed. Not yet.
What are these animals?
Gulon. Native to Vanaheim. Not sure what they're doing here.
Someone trained them to pull a sled. Lucky for us.
Domesticated Gulon. Most unusual.
I want the barrel. I want this chest.
Any particular direction to find your wounded animal? Or are we just enjoying the weather?
I can't hear anything out here.
Perhaps we find a cave first to catch our bearings?
think I know where it is. There it is.
Look! There's a cave entrance!
Yeah, this is... Oh, that's where I thought it was here. Huh.
This cave extends underneath the desert. Is the creature within?
Yeah. Sounds like it. We'll find it if we keep going. What is this place?
A refuge for the Dark Elves, by the looks of it. One of the few remaining now that they're barred from the temple.
Great. More about the Dark Elves. I wish we didn't have to fight them.
They attack us.
Well, this is their home. And considering what happened the last time we were in Alpha, can you really blame them?
Whoa.
Patience. A virtue or a threat?
Depends on the reader.
My heater again. Oh, oh hello. What have we here? Got him.
The creature you hired, what does it say now?
It's not always like that. Some animals are just... I feel what they're feeling, you know? And whatever this thing is, it's in a lot of pain.
I see.
Why do you ask?
I'm curious.
Really?
I am capable of curiosity.
Okay. Okay.
Andreas, excuse me, please. Thank you.
It's gonna
gonna explode!
Get away from me. Be gone with you. Get out of my face. And do this. And that. Open this up. So one, two, where's the third? It's up there. Oh, okay. Wait. I wonder. Nope. Gotta go for kidding me. Well.
I've never been this interested before. When I talk to animals or enchanted rings or whatever.
Much has changed for both of us.
Well, yeah. I'm just trying to figure out why you'd help some random animal.
Is this not what you want?
No, it is. I'm just surprised it's what you want, too.
Okay, there we go. We can do this now. Wait. Oh, never mind. Okay. Nope, wrong button. My bad. And away we go. Yep.
Subatina!
No, I don't want to abandon it. But if we have to kill a bunch of Dark Elves to get there,
I remember a young lad who, until this very moment, would take on an army of Draugr to save a wounded animal.
But these aren't undead Draugr. They're elves. I just want to make sure we're not repeating the same mistakes. Getting involved where we shouldn't.
Yeah. I'm also trying to remember where to go from here. Ah. Ran from my face, as usual. Excuse me. That is the wrong angle. Oh, wait. There we go. That's better.
It's just, why does it feel like no matter what we do in Alfheim, we wind up hurting Dark Elves?
We are down here to help protect you, herd.
I know that, but I'm usually the one who drags us around trying to rescue animals. Why do you care so much? Is there something you're not telling me?
No.
Okay.
Atreus, get out of my way! Good lord! That's more like it. I hear them, but I don't see them. Oh, there they are. Hello.
Oh, found it. What is it?
Great Gefyun's ghost. That's the largest bloody half goof I've ever laid eyes on.
It's not just in pain. It's trying to sing.
It's the song of the sands. They don't normally sing like this underground.
Is that what's causing the storm?
Aye. Judging by all this hive matter weighing it down, it's been trapped here for dozens of winters.
Don't worry, we'll get you out.
Oh.
What is that name?
Well, the last squid thingy we saw was Diener, so.
Oh boy. While I appreciate the attempt at humor, that little brother is truly awful wordplay. Embarrassing, really.
Oh, well, can't all be winners. There's gotta be a way to clear those rocks. Get a better angle. Go. like it can move now, but it still can't get out.
Much of the hive matter is gone. We can free it from the surface now.
And now we go back to where we came. Why? What in the world? There we go. Jesus.
Trap it down here. Half-gifers are known to burrow, so I'd hesitate to place full blame on our Dark Elf friends.
But it's trapped in their hive stuff.
Hive matter doesn't belong to the Dark Elves, any more than the light belongs to the Light Elves. It's just another of Alfheim's natural resources, one the Elves have used since the time of their ancestors. And while the Light Elves seem keen to banish the hive over on their side, the Dark Elves make effective use of it out here in the Barrens.
So, by clearing out all of this hive, are we hurting Dark Elves?
You wish to leave the creature enslaved?
No.
Then let us free it.
This is the spot! We can cut the half Koopa loose here! It flies?
Of course it flies! It's a half Koopa!
Sounds much happier now! And hey, the storm's gone!
Aye! Perhaps we'll finally earn some goodwill from our Dark Elf friends after all.
Look, Father, thanks for bringing us out here, but you don't have to do this kind of stuff just to keep my mind off Ragnarok, you know?
This was not a distraction.
No? Then why are we really out here?
Have you ever considered... He just wants to spend time with you, lad, while he still can.
Really?
We do not know what lies ahead, but if Ragnarok approaches, I wish to enjoy the time we have left.
Oh, my heart.
I don't know what to say. Thank you. for bringing us out here. I'm glad we did this.
As am I.
I missed a chest. Where? Where?
There's something I'm not sure I quite understand. In the Ragnarok prophecy, Odin knows, all the realms get destroyed, including Asgard. In the version Groa kept secret, Asgard still falls. Couldn't Odin have tried to prevent it either way?
Oh, okay. Here's...
What difference did her lie really make?
I think of it this way. When it comes to subverting prophecy, knowledge is power. Without the full picture and context, the finer details can lead you to tragically incorrect interpretations. Back in my homeland, I was privy to the operations of a certain coven of heath witches who were keen on destabilizing the government. They picked an influential thane, an otherwise loyal man, and fed him a story of his own ascension to king. They dressed it up in enough detail they knew would come to pass, so when they did, the thane took it as confirmation. Next thing you know, he's helping matters along. He murders his king, sleeping under his own roof. Murders many he once called friends, too, thinking them fated to oppose him. Then, for a finishing touch, the witches revisit this usurper. With just a few details, structured ever so misleadingly, they convinced the fool he was invulnerable to all threats.
Physical or magical?
Aye. But 'twas not so for him. All turned into a rather magnificent bloodbath as they go. The Thane ends up without his head and a name so cursed, none dare speak it. All thanks to a subtly deceptive prophecy.
You really gotta write these stories down one day, Mimir.
Well, I try. Jaw tends to get sore, but thank you, lad.